143. When you do evil or unfair things, irresponsible things, against people of your kind, fellow human beings, or against yourselves, against your inner nature or against your body or limbs, extremities, against life, the inner world consciousness, or the psyche, whether it be gruesome torture, or defilement, injury, or killing, then you are breaching the laws and recommendations of the wellspring of all love creation. Therefore you will not find any calm or any peace, or any freedom and consonance harmony in yourselves, because you cannot bring forth any benevolence or any forbearance for yourselves, and so you cannot forgive yourselves for your degenerated doings. 144. And whoever commits a non-right, that person only commits it against himself or herself, even if others are harmed thereby, because committing non-right against other people gives rise to harm in one's inner nature, and in addition it weighs on the admonishment conscience, sooner or later. 145. And as you commit non-right against the true prophets, so you take a decision that casts yourselves into ruin. But consider that you cannot do any harm to the true prophets, even if you slander, calumniate them and their teaching, if you stalk them and try to kill them, because also the true prophets know very well how to protect themselves, according to the laws and recommendations of the wellspring of true love creation. 146. Even before you, the prophets brought their teaching of truth, their teaching of spirit, their teaching of life to you, and taught your forefathers and foremothers, ancestors slash forebearers, everything that these did not know about all the knowledge and all the wisdom, and you also do not know it, because like those before you who neglected the teaching and kind-heartedness of the prophets, so you also neglect their great kind-heartedness and the teaching, because you plot, conspire, in secret talks against the teaching of truth and the true prophets, together with the priests and other servants and slash helpers of your fabulated, invented, and unsubstantial imaginary gods and tin gods. Truly, you do not conduct open talks on beneficence or kind-heartedness and bringing about peace in order to admonish the people of your kind human beings. When you come together in talks, it is only in striving for your own pleasure and to stir one another up for battles, wars, and to bring down punishments of death and acts of violence, torture, on people of your kind, fellow human beings, out of hatred and revenge and retribution, for which you fallaciously believe that a magnificent reward will be granted to you, and yet you are deluding yourselves vastly, because all your deeds are evil and against all laws and recommendations of the primal power creation, as have always been taught to you by the true prophets since time immemorial. 147. Whoever amongst you sets themselves against the teaching of truth, the teaching of spirit, the teaching of life, despite the fact that the right path to true existence has become clear to them, but nevertheless they follow a different path from that of the truth, they will have to follow a very difficult path, because they will cast themselves into a self-created shadow world, hell, as their own determination decision, and burn in its fire, and the path back to the truth will be 7 times worse for them than at the time when they first found their way to the truth. 148. One day, your distant descendants will not be able to forgive you for your showing contempt to and slandering, calumniate the teaching of the prophets and the prophets themselves, and being out for their blood, and therefore your distant descendants, grandchildren, etc., will not be able to forgive you, because you are leading them into delusion and far from the truth with your false teachings, your false prophets and your priests and other servants of gods and servants of tin gods, because your false teachings reach, extend slash carry themselves forwards into the farthest future and create delusion influence. Therefore your belief of your godliness religion, because you do not follow the teaching of the laws and recommendations of the wellspring of all life creation, but waste away far from it and from the wellspring of all life creation, by setting unsubstantial imaginary gods and tin gods at its side. 149. Truly, whoever sets fabulated, invented, gods or tin gods are fabulated, invented, representative substitutes, or others at the side of the primal wellspring of all wisdom, creation, is indeed going very far into delusion, and truly there are no gods or tin gods with who could be creators, originators, of the firmament's universe, and of the earth's worlds slash planets, and the heavenly lights celestial bodies slash comets slash planets slash moons slash meteors slash shooting stars slash nebulae, because the creation of all things in all firmaments in the universe, and on all earth's worlds slash planets, is solely due to the primal wellspring of all wisdom creation, because truly it alone is the creative force energy of all things and the immeasurable secret. 150. Those amongst you who have fallen prey to belief assumptions in your priests and other servants' hands slash hell press of godliness religion, and who make prayers invocations slash edification to gods and tin gods, truly you are only calling on lifeless and unsubstantial things, imaginary slash non-existent things, and are thereby cursing the truth of creation. So you are evil and indignant ones against the truth and against the laws and recommendations of creation. 151. And those amongst you who call on unsubstantial imaginary gods and tin gods, you are cursing yourselves, and truly you are servants' hands slash hell press of your own suffering, which strikes you at all times through your own irrationality. Lend your ear to the true prophets and to their teaching, because truly it is they alone who do not lead you into confusion, who do not lead you into hatred and battle war, neither into revenge or retribution, and nor into punishment with acts of gavalt or into killing. And it is only the true prophets who bring you the teaching of truth, of love and harmony, freedom and peace, and who do not stir up vain wishes in you and do not goad you into blindness fanaticism, through which you kill your life, commit suicide, in order to kill many others' murderous attacks, because you are led into confusion by blind belief and have fallen prey to a hazy picture delusion. 153. Truly, you shall not cut off the ears of animals, not torment any animals, and not deface or destroy anything that is given by the wellspring of all wisdom creation in the firmament's universe and on earth's worlds slash planets, and anyone who does so nonetheless stands in friendship with evil and wreaks evident loss all around to what has been given by the wellspring of all wisdom creation to all life for joy and for benefit, prosperity, and for the preservation of existence. 154. Consider that false prophets and priests, as well as all other servants of gods and servants of tin gods and all the rest in groups who are secessionists from the truth sectists, or those who glorify themselves as give themselves out as slash give themselves airs as divinities and heightened ones, sublime ones, or as sect leaders, are fooling you with promises and stirring up desires, vices slash wantonness slash addictions slash urges in you, and wishes of degeneration, degeneracy, and non-right, because they are seducers and everything that they promise is vain delusiveness. 155. And truly, if you follow the seducers, then you will find no way to escape from the darkness of your iniquity, unfairness, and non-righteousness, conscienceless. So you will continue to founder without knowing the truth and without giving the virtues enough consideration. 156. Truly, all those amongst you who do your good deeds and are connected to the truth and the laws and recommendations of the primal wellspring creation, you will create gardens of happiness within yourselves and cultivate, grow, plants of love and of knowing and of wisdom, and streams of joy and of well-being will flow through the garden and allow peace and freedom and consonance harmony to prosper therein. This garden is your inner paradise, which will forever well live in you for as long as you hold firm to it unswervingly and truthfully, and care for your inner realm of pleasure, realm of the firmament slash paradise,